Uttanka was a scholarly Brahmin who lived in the Maru desert. The story of the Uttanka clouds are quite fascinating. The onset of summer must be making us think of water. Krishna was returning to Dwaraka after the Kurukshetra war. Yudhishthira had been coronated as the king of Hastinapura. And on his way back, Uttanka met Lord Krishna. The innocent recluse just wanted to know how the Kauravas and Pandavas were faring and that if they had resolved their differences. Krishna had to tell him that the great war had taken place and all the Kauravas were dead and that the Pandava prince Yudhishthira was now King Yudhishthira. Immediately Uttanka was very upset. He told Krishna, "You are a great person and in spite of your presence, how can you let it happen? Now let me curse you." Immediately the great Krishna told Uttanka, "O great sage, do not waste your energy in trying to curse me. I tried my best, but whatever had to happen, happened." And then he blessed Uttanka with the vision of the Vishwarupa. Only Arjuna and Bhishma had seen the full form of Vishwarupa, and Uttanka was the third person. And later, Krishna asked if Uttanka wanted any other boon. Uttanka said that he just had enough because he's seen the Vishwarupa. However, Krishna insisted, and therefore Uttanka told him, "Oh Krishna, please give me water whenever I want." And Krishna immediately agreed. It was a hot summer day in the desert, and Uttanka was quite thirsty. He immediately thought of Lord Krishna, requested Lord Krishna mentally to give him water. In a few minutes from then, he got to see a Nishada with 5 dots and a deer skin full of water. The Nishada offered Uttanka water in his little bamboo container. Uttanka refused to take that. And in a while, the Nishada disappeared. Then immediately Krishna came over to that place and told Uttanka that he had missed a marvelous chance. Uttanka said, "Oh well, there was just a Nishada who gave me water. And what, Krishna? And I want water. Is this the way that you should give me?" Krishna tells him, "Uttanka, the subject is more important and not who is getting it to you. It is very, very important for you to understand that your thirst had to be quenched." And Uttanka becomes silent. Then Krishna tells Uttanka, "Hey Uttanka, do you know something? I told Indra to give you the nectar or the amrit when you felt thirsty today. However, Indra said it was only for great people and not for ordinary mortals. I had told Indra that, Uttanka, you are a great man. However, Indra persisted and he came in the form of a Nishada and handed over the nectar to you in this tiny bamboo container. However, you observed that it was a Nishada and refused to take amrit or nectar. Therefore, you missed a golden opportunity." Uttanka felt really bad. He had water from whatever was offered. And then Krishna blessed him and told Uttanka that he would always get water whenever he wanted, wherever he was, and clouds would be formed over him and it would rain and he would get the water. So whenever Uttanka moved around, he had clouds in the desert, and whenever that he wanted water, he got water. And these clouds in the desert, which offer water to the needy ones like Uttanka, are known as the Uttanka clouds. Let us remember that knowledge and water are very, very important, and that we should know how to harvest them at the right place and time and ensure that we put it to good use. The story of this great Uttanka is a marvelous example, and let us all learn from this story. Vande Mataram.